there is a common misconception about Mother Nature. You see, when most people think of Mother Nature, they think of green trees, blue oceans, flowers, rainbows, cute baby duckies, you know, calming stuff. But the Earth holds a deep, dark secret. Charles Darwin discovered this secret over 150 years ago, and despite tons of physical proof, the secret remains ignored by the majority of people. It is very clear that Mother Nature, the Earth, has very limited resources. It is difficult for people to understand this, seeing as how our shelves are always stocked, our lights always turn on, and if things become cramped, there is always another place to move. But imagine, and I know this is a huge step, but think, life forms other than human beings don't have access to the conveniences we call our standard of living. When a lion gets hungry, it has to chase, expending massive amounts of energy to catch its meal. And 9 times out of 10, it will fail, and its meal will run off. That lion, now tired and hungry, just watched the only thing that will keep it alive slip away. But now, imagine it from the zebra's perspective. You just stare death in the face and think how lucky you are to be alive. But imagine if the lion wins. Your life has been ripped from you in an instant as you become the life of the lion. You, the zebra, everything about you, all your traits, wits, kindness, all of your genes are stripped away from this earth. You are eliminated from your population. Your legacy just died in the fangs of the lion. You are gone, and Mother Earth does not mourn you. Imagine it, your being, your soul, gone. And yet Mother Nature applauds the lion. Now you may think that the lion reaps its reward, but no, the lion must face another challenge, her peers. Other lions want what she has. Tired and starving, the lion must now defend her meal. It is possible that she will fail, watching the only thing that will keep her alive slip away to a bigger, stronger lion. So you see, life is hard for life, and yet Mother Nature stands by unwilling to help. In fact, Mother Nature makes finding resources even harder. It is difficult to imagine, but a mate is a resource. New life is not created in an instant. The miracle of life must gestate from an egg. Only females are given this power. But Mother Nature once again makes it difficult, as females cannot produce an unlimited amount of eggs. New life takes weeks, months, possibly even years to be created. Each new egg is precious, as it is the vehicle that will allow a species to keep existing on our insignificant rock. Males must expend massive amounts of energy to ensure their contribution enters the next generation. Some males will fight to the death to ensure the continuation of their kind. Other males are lucky to even be chosen by females. Mother Nature, once again, does not mourn those that have lost their lives, lost their genes, lost their legacy. Mother Nature applauds those that have won. Sometimes Mother Nature even throws life a curveball. Sometimes Mother Nature will eliminate organisms regardless of their ability to secure a mate or find food. Occasionally, Mother Nature eliminates creatures on a larger scale. And even recently, Mother Nature has a new curveball capable of eliminating creatures on a global scale. Mother Nature does not mourn even her fittest creatures. If she did, then we would still see dinosaurs around today. Mother Nature cares only of one thing, the survival of life forms that have conquered each and every obstacle that she designed. So you see, Mother Nature is not the giver of life, but rather the bringer of death. Mother Nature tries to cook up different ways of eliminating life and trimming the fat. Life tries to fight back by producing as much life as possible, but she wants nothing but only her fittest creatures to survive and pass along their traits. This concept is difficult to comprehend because humans are not subjected to the same evolutionary forces like our cousins. We, humans, control our environment. We make it comfortable and safe for our own kind. Yet in doing so, we destroy countless habitats and kill billions of creatures. But you see, Mother Nature is the smartest force in the universe and can only be pushed so far until she pushes back. We are only now beginning to see the power of her roar. Some may look at this way of thinking and feel small, helpless, or worthless. Some may even disagree. But I feel big! We are here thanks to the death of trillions of souls and, against all odds, the success of a few. Your life continues thanks to the slaughter of thousands of creatures each and every day. You are unique. It is often said that when you die, your life flashes before your eyes. You have a choice. What will you want to watch? You have the choice. What legacy will you leave?